Hey there, Bridge family. It's Pastor Jeff. And today I'd like to speak to you one more time about biblical faith and the role that it could and should play in each of our lives. If you are a true biblical Christian, then that means you've been given by grace a faith that should literally define and describe your life. I pray that you are walking that narrow road of biblical faith, and in so doing, that you're demonstrating to the world the glory of our God. You're demonstrating through your walk of faith that you're in the very family of God, and that you have received this miraculous gift of amazing grace that leads you to live a life on mission. I was reminded this morning of two inspirational accounts. One from literally 500 years ago, and then another from about 15 minutes ago. You see, the account from 500 years ago was that of Thomas Hawker. Thomas Hawker, I shared his account in last Sunday's sermon. He was one who demonstrated that God's grace was enough to live by faith even as he was brought into the flames of martyrdom. He was literally burned at the stake, and to answer the request of a friend who said, "Thomas, if God's grace is really enough, as you burn, would you please lift your arms up to the sky as a way of showing me that God's grace carried you through the flames all the way into God's presence?" And Thomas Hawker did just that. With his fingers burnt off as the flames were raging, his arms were thrusted up into the sky, and with the nubs of his hands, he began to clap. And those that were there, history tells us, they burst into praise and worship of the one true living God. Now that's an inspirational account. Well, it wasn't long ago this morning with our sister Vicky in Jinja, Uganda. She recounted her understanding and her blessing of hearing of Thomas Hawker's faith. And she said to me what was almost just as inspiring. She said to me and the other brothers and sisters, "This account of Thomas Hawker's faith has blessed and inspired me." And as she shared her account of her inspiration, it in turn inspired me. For you see, Vicky said, "I've come to realize that I tend to grumble, and I don't walk by the faith that I claim to have. And praise God, he's refining me by showing me this. And I've come to realize that I don't live in the flames that Thomas Hawker had." And let me just be quick to tell you that my sister Vicky, our sister Vicky, she doesn't live in the midst of great comfort. She has her own very real struggles. And yet she said, "I've come to realize that compared to Thomas Hawker, my life is very comfortable. I don't know the flames of Thomas Hawker, and yet my arms stay down." I believe that through this better understanding, said Vicky, that I now am inspired to live with my arms lifted up every day as a demonstration of not only praise, but to the fact that God's grace is enough. When I've received the gospel of Jesus Christ, his grace is enough to empower my walking by faith no matter what. Friend, I pray that whether it's Thomas Hawker or our sister Vicky in Jinja, I pray that you are hearing and heeding the word of God in a way that fuels your inspiration and by faith fuels your ability to inspire others as a walking witness, filled with worship, ready for warfare, walking the walk that is truth in love, all by God's grace, and as always, all for his glory. Amen and amen.